Good morning, children. Today we will discuss this trigonometric ratios of complementary angles. You have already learned how to find the trigonometric ratios of sine theta, cos theta and tan theta. So today our topic is trigonometric ratios of complementary angles. You see, I will make a right angle triangle. This is ABC. It is a right angle triangle. Let this angle base angle. I will take base angle. This is theta. If you see, this is 90 degree. This is theta. So this angle will be 90 minus theta. Why? Because sum of three angles apply the angle sum property. It is 90 plus theta plus 90 minus theta. So it is 180 degree. So if you write down this theta, this will be 90 minus theta. Right? Now we will find the complementary angles. You see, what is sine theta equal? You always you write this PBP divided by HHB. This is for sine, this is for cos, this is for tan. Some people have curly black hair to present beauty. You know this sine theta equal to, this is the base angle here. Sine theta is perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So I will write it is perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Sine theta is what is perpendicular? It is AB here. Perpendicular is AB and hypotenuse is AC. AB by AC. If I will write cos theta is base upon hypotenuse. You see, cos theta is base upon hypotenuse. Base is BC, hypotenuse is AC. Cos theta is base upon hypotenuse. Base is BC and hypotenuse is AC. Now, what is the complementary angle? Sine of 90 minus theta. What you will do for these complementary angles? So, when you have to find complementary angle, this angle, then this will become the perpendicular BC and this will become the base. But don't do this. I will make change here. You remember, when it is complementary angle, then for this perpendicular you write down base, right? For this perpendicular you write down base when it is perpendicular, this vertical angle here. So it is base upon hypotenuse. I will not change this. This will be base, this is perpendicular, but you make change here. So when you write this sine of 90 minus theta, this vertical angle you change. For perpendicular I will write base, and for base I will write perpendicular. So sine of 90 minus theta, now this is vertical angle, it is perpendicular upon hypotenuse if it is base angle, but it is vertical angle, I will write base upon hypotenuse. So this is equal to base upon hypotenuse. Base is BC, hypotenuse is AC. Now what is cos of 90 minus theta? Cos of 90 minus theta is again base upon hypotenuse, but this is vertical angle, you write down perpendicular upon hypotenuse. It is perpendicular upon hypotenuse for vertical angle, for vertical angle. So cos theta is perpendicular, that is AB upon hypotenuse is AC. Now what you will remember from this, AB by AC, this is AB by AC, this is also AB by AC. If you equate the two results, you will get sine theta from the above this discussion, above calculation, we will find sine theta is equal to cos of 90 minus theta. So we can write for sine theta, it is sine theta is cos of 90 minus theta. You see, AB by AC, AB by AC, the RHS part is same in both, right? So I will write sine theta is equal to cos theta. Now you see cos theta here, cos theta is BC upon AC. You see cos theta is, sine theta is BC upon AC. I will make these two equal, that is cos theta equal to sine of 90 minus theta, sine of 90 minus theta. So what you have to remember, when sine theta is equal to cos of 90 minus theta and cos theta is equal to sine of 90 minus theta. So I will find, though it has been deleted by the CBSE board, but this is motivation for you, right? We can use this in the next chapter, that is heights and distances, the complementary angles, how sine theta is changing into cos theta and cos theta is changing into sine theta here. Thank you.